Hello, I hope you are well and that your businesses are doing well also. In the video of today, I will talk about should we sell our agricultural products on social media. You know, nowadays, almost everybody is on social media, almost every company is on social media, and sometimes I see people posting on social media after harvesting their cassava, their tomato, or even sometimes after they have finished to raise their chicken or their pork, they put on social media and say, I'm selling chicken, I'm selling tomato. And the question that I always ask myself is it really important for them to sell on social media? Or when they do those posts on social media concerning their agricultural product, should they really sell their product using social media? Before I did this video, I went to do some research concerning the major companies that are doing well in agriculture in Africa, and I tried to look if they are on social media, and even if they are there, how are they managed when they are on social media? And after my research, I've drawn some conclusion that I will share with you during these videos. During my research, I found the list of the 10 richest farmers in the world that I did in one of my previous videos. And what I noticed is that most of those farmers are not even on internet. It was even difficult for me to go and find their pictures on internet because they are not there. So, are they doing bad not being in social media, or is it affecting their business when they are not on social media? It's true that nowadays people will say on social media that if your business is not on social media, you are missing something. Maybe they are right or maybe they are wrong. But in this video, I will let you know what I found as a result, and me as a farmer, I will tell you how I sell my stuff that I produce here. Is it on social media? Is it on face-to-face? That will be what I will discuss during this video. First of all, what I noticed is that many people that get into selling even their agricultural product or any other product, their problem is that they don't know who is their customer. When you take what you have produced, maybe cassava or corn, and you post it on Facebook or Instagram saying that you are selling corn, if your customers are on Instagram or on Facebook. So when you start a business, the first thing you must do is, the first question you must ask yourself is, who are really my customers? There is a company in Cameroon that is the number one company as far as poultry industry is concerned. Recently, I was looking about that company on internet, and let me tell you that they had no presence on internet, zero presence on internet. And there are even more companies like that in Africa that are doing really well, but they are not internet. Why are they not there? Because their customers are not on internet. So when you are doing agriculture and farming, you really have to know who are your customers. Recently, when I was trying to help my dad to put his company's website on the internet, he's on construction, I tried to convince him that internet is good for him, and that concerning his business, he needed more visibility, he needed to be on internet. I even created a Facebook page for him, an Instagram page for his company. He let me do that, but he told me that 95% of the client that he gets and that he has been getting since he started his business are just by recommendation. But he let me do this website because he told me that you are young, internet is for your age. Maybe by internet you will find some client. But let me tell you that since I am in the construction business, I've almost never had a client that was coming through internet. So I take the money and I went to see a website designer that designed the website for me, and it was really cool. After 1 year, no one client. 2 years, no clients. And after, I had to shut the website down because I noticed that the customers of the construction business are not on internet. So it's the same thing when you are doing agriculture. Most of the time, you will never see me posting on internet that I have corn to sell, that I have chicken to sell, I have pork to send, because I know who are my customers. I know where I will find them. There are many of my customers that even have an Android phone. So if I want to meet them, internet is not the way that I will use to go and meet those customers. When I want to meet them, I give them a phone call, I take an appointment, and I travel to see them to know what they really need. How are they finding my product? Am I going to improve something, or is there something that I should do to satisfy them even more than what I did before? But if I try to do that on internet, I will not be successful, because if I try to put my products on internet, I'll be doing wrong because I'll be targeting the wrong customer. The second reason why I don't advise you to sell your agricultural products on internet is because you are taking the risk of exposing yourself to a wide variety of people that may be your customers, and if they really decide to contact you to deliver it to them, you are not going to deliver what they are expecting to you, and that's going to destroy your credibility. Let's take an example. If you are producing soybean, for example, and you post on internet that you are producing soybean, someone can contact you and say, okay, can you supply me 50 tons of soybean every month? If you cannot, that will really ruin your credibility. But I'll advise you that when you go on internet to post your product, let it be that you really have the possibility to afford, or you really have the possibility to supply the high demand that may come through the internet. Even that is really difficult to see someone giving you a high demand concerning the internet. Most of the companies that are here in Cameroon, when they want to buy corn, even the multinationals that are here in Cameroon, they go on the market to see their sellers face to face. So in Africa, concerning agricultural product, I don't really advise you to go on social media. And even if you go on social media, because many people will ask me and say, you are on social media, you are on YouTube, you are on Facebook, you are on Instagram, so what are you doing there? My purpose for being on the internet is not for sale, is to raise the awareness of many Africans concerning the importance of agriculture. Because you see, what I'm doing is just a little bit of what can be done in Africa. And you know, in 2050, the population of Africa will double. So being in agriculture, I see the opportunity that exists in agriculture. That's why I share it with you guys, so that even you can do more than what I am doing now to make Africa become independent as far as food is concerned. So thank you for watching this video. If you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing and have a good time. Thank you.